As of September 21st of 2025, there are currently 45 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is 2 less than were erupting last week. One of these erupting volcanoes is the Democratic Republic of the Congo's Nyiragongo volcano, which contains the world's largest active lava lake at the present. While its size has varied during the last 360 years, it has been measured anywhere from 60 to a whopping 1,000 meters wide. This lava lake, which is incredibly low in silica, typically builds over multiple years until being catastrophically released downslope, where its molten rock flows at speeds of up to 60 miles per hour in dangerous flank eruptions. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In the Philippines, an unusually intense earthquake storm occurred at the Kanlaon volcano, which soon after produced another eruption. Meanwhile, in the state of Washington, airborne volcanic ash was recorded from the area of Mount Saint Helens, with some communities across parts of the state later reporting some ashfall. And in what is this week's top story, Kilauea erupted anew, producing a series of spectacular towering and tilted lava fountains for a full 9 hours straight, creating a spectacle that was widely viewed. These lava fountains at their peak reached a height of 240 meters or 787 feet, marking Kilauea's tallest lava fountain since the beginning of July. Thankfully, all of this was completely confined harmlessly within Kilauea's summit caldera, where there are no structures. Since December 23rd of last year, Kilauea has been undergoing a fairly predictable episodic eruptive cycle that has repeated and thus culminated in a phase of tall lava fountains a total of 33 times now. The latest particular phase began at 3:11 a.m. on September 19th when weaker overflows of lava from its two summit vents transitioned into a continuous lava fountain. This lava fountain slowly grew in height until the continuous mass of 1200 degrees Celsius or 2192 degrees Fahrenheit of fresh basaltic lava reached its peak height 1 to 2 hours in. Thereafter, non-stop lava fountaining continued, with the height and rate of erupting molten rock subsequently decreased. Regardless, lava went on to fill about two-thirds of the 2018 caldera's surface, adding several more feet elevation to the crater floor. Eruptive activity ceased at 12:08 p.m., and now, the 34th episode of lava fountaining, in my opinion, is most likely to occur sometime between September 29th and October 7th. Meanwhile, in the state of Washington, airborne ash was reported in the proximity of Mount St. Helens during the morning of September 16th. But fear not, this was not due to a new or ongoing volcanic eruption. Instead, strong winds were to blame, which for a time were continuously blowing at speeds of 45 miles per hour. These winds picked up some of the abundant loose ash still present from its major 1980 eruption, causing many particles to become airborne. These then traveled up to 25 miles to the north, staying at elevations 10,000 feet or less. As for the reports of ash even further north in the state, despite falling at about the same time, that ashfall was of a different origin, created by the major Bear Gulch wildfire in Olympic National Park. And, once again, Mount St. Helens is not currently showing any strong signs of unrest. Meanwhile, in the Philippines, the Kanlaon volcano somewhat unexpectedly produced its strongest volcanic earthquake in more than a decade when, on September 14th, a magnitude 4.6 quake struck. This triggered a swarm of earthquakes, which across the next 3 days involved 300 events, including at least one magnitude 3 range quake. While these quakes were all too small to cause any damage, their occurrence indicates the likely still ongoing buildup of pressure and heat in Kilauea's hydrothermal system. This is why it erupted twice during the prior week. And on September 18th, Kanlaon erupted again, with one ash emission lasting for 2 minutes and a second weak ash emission event from its summit lasting for 69 minutes. In my opinion, more similar intensity ash emissions are likely across the next week. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on September 20th of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.